This is MRN Out Loud, brought to you by Hercules Tires.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to another edition of MRN Out Loud. Headed to Las Vegas Motor Speedway this weekend, where the Xfinity Series playoffs open up, and we have a Vegas native on the program. Riley Herbst drives the number 98 Ford Mustangs for Stuart Haas Racing. He'll tell us about that and about some cool things to check out while you're there away from the racetrack. It's all ahead on this week's edition of MRN Out Loud. Stay with us.
Gamers, start your engines. Meet the next generation of racing wheels. The award-winning Logitech G design is re-engineered to dial into your game physics, delivering unprecedented realism. You'll every shift, drift, and hairpin turn like never before. Our latest innovation in force feedback technology connects directly to endgame simulation engines and physics to produce higher fidelity, real-time responses. Through design, engineering, and the love of driving games, Logitech G takes racing simulation to another level. Go to logitechg.com.
Citywide to countryside, whatever you drive, wherever you go, Hercules has the value, selection, and industry-leading warranty to get you there no matter where the road takes you. Go to HerculesTires.com. There you can find the nearest authorized Hercules retail location to you. Plus, you can use the tire tracker to find out which Hercules tire fits your vehicle the best. That's HerculesTires.com. Hercules Tires, ride on our strength.
Riley Herbst joins us now. He is the 11th seed heading into the playoffs. He drives the number 98 Ford Mustangs for Stuart Haas Racing. And as a Vegas native, you have to be thrilled with where this thing is starting, don't you?
Oh, yeah. I'm really excited to get back home, go see my family and friends, and hopefully take them on a tour in Victory Lane out there.
Are you already getting hit up with ticket requests like, hey, Riley, can you get me a seat?
A little bit, but I'd rather have it that way than nobody asked for tickets. So I think it's a good thing.
Let's start with the big picture. The season didn't start off the way you wanted. Three wrecks in the first four races, none of which were your doing. So at that time in the year, what was going through your mind and how were you able to tell yourself, this will pass if I just stay calm?
Yeah, it was a little frustrating, actually a lot frustrating to be honest with you. But like you said, we had good pace those first three races. So that's what we kind of told ourselves in the 98 camp and said if we have to keep being consistent and get through each race and end up in the playoffs and try to go race them at Las Vegas.
Now you come in with a little bit of momentum, a couple of straight top fives. How do you evaluate this format compared to the regular season that we just talked about where you can kind of say, okay, we've got next week. Now that next week is only three races long.
Yeah, you're right about that. Definitely a little bit more wild, more intense, you could say, just because you got three races to get it done. But I think this first round, if you get three really consistent, probably pretty smooth races, you can transfer to the round of eight on a good note.
The other races are Talladega and the Roval. Talladega is just such a crazy one, but you came out pretty good, a top five there the first time this year. Is that a race where something like that makes you go, phew, I'm glad we made it? Because unlike most tracks, you can do everything completely right and still wind up with a wrecked race car.
Yeah, I don't really know if past history reflects future results at Talladega just because so many different variables. So although it was good to get a top five earlier there in the spring, I think going into the fall, people are going to throw a little bit bigger blocks and going to race a little bit harder just because it is a playoff race. So hopefully we can work with our Ford teammates and try to get in their top five finish and head to the Roval.
That teammates thing has become such a big deal on these super speedways, but you can't always, I mean, everybody has a plan going in, but it seems like at Talladega and Daytona more so than others, that can just go out the window in half a lap. So how do you keep focused knowing, man, I really want to do this, but I can't right now?
Yeah, I think a lot of it is just pre-race work with those teammates and being committed to each other throughout the race. And then have a cutoff or have a deadline when you start to race for yourselves and when the pay window is open.
What was the race that you felt the best about this year and the one that you wish you could have back the most?
Man, I wish we could the best race would probably be Charlotte. We showed really good pace there, got the pole, led practice, led some laps early in the race, and we just kind of missed the adjustments a little bit later on in the race. And the race I wish we could have back would probably be Pocono. Had a few pit road penalties, but we were fast and got caught up in a wreck deep in the field. So Pocono and Charlotte, both good races for us, but for opposite reasons.
I'm glad you mentioned Charlotte, because the last race, the cutoff race in round one, is the Roval. But you've done really well on the road courses this year. Top 10 at Indy, top 10 at Road America. How do you feel about your road racing program?
I think it's good. I think we should have had a top five at Mid-Ohio. Got taken out there on the final lap. And then we were running third at the Daytona road course earlier in the year, and they wrecked in front of us. So I think our road course program is really good here on the 98 team. And like I said, we're looking forward to Las Vegas. We got to get through Talladega, and then the Roval is a great opportunity for us to capitalize on some points.
That Roval was a monsoon last year, but I'm curious, when you approach a road course, do you have the same, plan is not necessarily the right word, but that's the best one I can think of going in terms of, I got to be just super smooth? Or, you know, back in the day, a lot of guys used to be just super aggressive and throw the car around in all the turns. How do you approach it?
I don't know. I just try to hit my marks and just try to get through each lap, because each lap the tires fall off. And you got to hit your marks. You got to hit your shifts points right. And if you don't do that, then your day is going to be over real early. But if you hit your shifts right, hit your apexes, then you'll have something to race them at the end.
Let's finish with a couple of fun ones. I saw some of your social media earlier about Operation Wake Surf. Tell me about that, because it looked like it was really cool.
It's very cool. It's a really cool program that my buddy Robbie does out here in Lake Norman. And he gets veterans and people who used to serve for this great country or still serve. And we take them out wake surfing out on the lake out here in Lake Norman. And they get a couple shop tours throughout local shops here in Concord and Charlotte. And they get to do some pit practice, see what it's like changing tires, jacking up the race car. So that was a really cool deal to be involved in. And hopefully we can do it again next year.
Let's finish with where we started, Las Vegas. Every native that I've talked to doesn't really mess with the strip and all that stuff. So tell me some things that folks might like to do outside of the strip that are pretty cool from a native's perspective, and a really good place to eat that may not be on the radar so much.
So there's a couple places to eat, but I feel like me and Noah have kind of already spilled the beans on this place a little bit. But there's a small hole in the wall in downtown called La Thai. It's phenomenal food. We love that place. But things to do is Red Rock Canyon's really close to where I grew up on the outskirts of Las Vegas. So that was always fun to go out to in the cooler summer mornings or the late summer afternoons to go hike with your buddies and things like that. But there's quite a few things to do out in Las Vegas. So it's a lot of fun.
I did try La Thai after Noah recommended it, and you guys are right. It's fantastic. Riley, thanks for your time. Good luck in the playoffs, man. It's here. It's finally here.
Let's get it. Thank you.
Sir, are you aware you were going 40 miles an hour? This is a residential area.
Sure, but I'm on my lawnmower. Wait, am I getting a ticket?
No, I've just never seen anyone top 9 miles an hour on one of those bad boys. And mow their entire lawn in 30 seconds? What got into you?
Well, it did fuel up at Sunoco this morning.
At Sunoco, we know how to fuel peak performance. We've been doing it for American racing for over 50 years. Fuel your best.
Well, it's down to the final two races of the season. Only virtual Talladega Super Speedway and Texas Motor Speedway are left before we have a champion. The third round of the playoffs will be on Tuesday, September 28th at the virtual Talladega Super Speedway. Catch all the action and the iRacing countdown to green at enascar.com/live at 8:30 p.m. with the race starting on enascar.com at 9 p.m. Eastern Time on Tuesday, September the 28th. Go to iRacing.com for all the latest news, feature videos, and more information on the world of iRacing. This iRacing update is brought to you by Logitech G. Through design, engineering, and a love of driving games, the Logitech G923 takes racing simulation to another level. Logitech G, the official wheels and pedals of the eNASCAR Coca-Cola iRacing series.
Citywide to countryside, whatever you drive, wherever you go, Hercules has the value, selection, and industry-leading warranty to get you there no matter where the road takes you. Go to HerculesTires.com. There you can find the nearest authorized Hercules retail location to you. Plus, you can use the tire tracker to find out which Hercules tire fits your vehicle the best. That's HerculesTires.com. Hercules Tires, ride on our strength.
That's all the time we've got on this week's edition of MRN Out Loud. We want to thank Riley Herbst for joining us as he gets set to open the Xfinity Series playoffs at his home track Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Until we see you right back here next week, I'm Woody Kane saying thanks for joining us for MRN Out Loud.